In this video, we will explore one of the fundamental graphic projection techniques used in various visual designs alongside architectural drawings, namely linear perspective.
Jessica. 안녕하세요. HS 건축학 결론입니다.
In our previous videos, we explored drawing techniques like axonometric and oblique, along with plan, section, and elevation, all falling within the realm of parallel projection. In addition to these, another graphic projection technique employed in comprehensive architectural drawings is perspective. Perspective drawings establish another essential axis, crafted to represent objects observed most realistically through the eyes of a living organism. Among these techniques, linear perspective stands out as a fundamental projection type widely utilized in various visual design fields. Okay. Linear perspective is a drawing technique that portrays space based on the scale that varies with the distance between the observer and the object. In this case, objects farther from the observer are depicted smaller. While it may seem like an obvious principle, it wasn't until the Renaissance era that this drawing technique acquired its name. Developed starting with the Italian architect Filippo Brunelleschi, linear perspective evolved further with Leon Battista Alberti's De Pictura, based on Euclidean geometry, enabling precise distance measurements in drawing. Linear perspective drawing possesses a mechanism closely resembling the fundamental principles by which our eyes perceive objects. As explained in our previous videos on light and illumination, we perceive objects through the rays entering the retina of our eyes. These rays converge and refract at a specific point, projecting the image of a particular object onto the retina. Consequently, objects at a distance appear smaller and with sharper angles as rays enter our eyes, resulting in our perception of the object in a reduced form. This forms the basis for estimating the size and depth of space. Linear perspective applies these principles to flat drawings, allowing us to sense a three-dimensional spatial perception. First, the horizontal line serves as a baseline for depicting objects at different distances when viewed from a specific eye level of the observer. Since the eye level can vary based on the observer's position and size, its placement may differ slightly up or down. Therefore, depending on the drawing intention, adjusting the height of this horizontal line enables various types of linear perspective drawings, including bird's eye view and worm's eye view. Additionally, the vanishing point serves as a focal point for depicting variations in the sizes of different objects and spatial depth based on distance. Positioned on the horizontal line, it's the point where all parallel lines in the drawing converge. As the term suggests, this allows for the representation of objects that diminish in size and spaces that vanish into the distance as they move away from the observer. Depending on the precision and complexity required in depicting objects, it can be applied in various ways, such as one-point perspective, two-point perspective, and multi-point perspective. In addition, other key terms used in linear perspective drawing include orthogonal lines, representing the orthogonal reference lines in actual space, the ground plane, indicating the surface where objects are located, and vanishing lines, which connect to the vanishing point. The characteristics of drawings based on the fundamental elements of linear perspective vary, and consequently, their applications and techniques are equally diverse. Firstly, drawings aligned with the human eye's height on the horizontal line are suitable for depicting various architecture, cities, and natural environments we experience in our daily lives. Drawings with a higher horizontal line, known as bird's eye view drawings, describe the overall appearance of a specific site or project and imply a superior observer's perspective. Conversely, drawings with a lower horizontal line, known as worm's eye view drawings, are well suited for portraying spatial height and upper objects like ceilings, emphasizing the grandeur and largeness of the depicted objects. One point perspective with a single vanishing point helps the observer focus on a single plane, object, or space, while two-point perspective drawings are useful for depicting corners of objects or city streets, and three-point perspective drawings used in conjunction with bird's eye view and worm's eye view emphasize the three-dimensionality of object. Now it's a quiz time. Shall we test your understanding of linear perspective? Many of the buildings we find in our surroundings have distinct corners due to their characteristic of enclosing space with wall surfaces. Additionally, for usability, they often have one or more access points. Reflecting these typical features of architecture, what drawing technique is commonly used today to depict various architectural and urban scenes? Great! So, feeling more comfortable with the basics of perspective drawings now? I hope this provides you with an opportunity to explore suitable drawing techniques to effectively convey the characteristics of the objects and spaces